Hi everyone, I hope you're all well. So, today's video, I want you guys to go and get some snacks, get a drink. I want you guys to make sure you are subscribed to me and make sure you have the notifications on so you're notified when I post videos. And I know recently I've been a very bad YouTuber, I've not been posting regularly, but I am trying my best to get back into it, and I really, 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 really appreciate your support so much, and I love you guys so much. I attempted to dye my hair red. It didn't really work that well, but I now do my brows the same color as whatever that color my hair is. So yeah, I am gonna attempt to dye it again and make it as red as possible because I don't want to use bleach, and my hair's really black, so it's really difficult to dye any color, to be honest. I'm gonna start with what I've been using a lot in my recent makeup videos, and it's the Kiehl's Daily Revive face oil. I really, really like this stuff, and I love using it under makeup. And it's not really like an oily oil, it's quite a dry oil, so it doesn't really feel like my face is super oily or anything. Speaking of skin, I really want to do a skincare video soon. I'm also using the Kiehl's Ultra Facial Cream. It's like my favorite moisturizer right now, and I'm just gonna use that liberally all over the face. I've just moisturized my skin, so my skin's feeling awesome right now, and I'm gonna go straight into my eyebrows. Now, a lot of the products I'm using today are small Instagram brands. For my eyebrows, I'm actually gonna be using a lip liner to begin with. Obviously, I'm gonna be using, as I mentioned earlier, I'm gonna be using a burgundy color to match my hair. I'm gonna just comb through my brows to begin with, like so. And then I'm gonna take this pencil, and it's by Per Cosmetics. I'll put their name below, and it's in the shade Vamp. So I'm gonna use this. Ooh, guys, look how pigmented that is. I barely even put it in my brow. I'm gonna be using a brow brush to kind of brush the product and kind of spread it a little bit, because it is really pigmented and thick, and it's kind of just sitting in one place. I've never actually used this for brows, so yeah, I'm a little bit like, ooh, I'm trying to control the situation. Look how well that covered up my natural brow color though. I know I look really stupid right now, but I'm gonna take a dark maroon shadow, taking this one from the Huda Beauty palette, the rose gold palette, and it's called Coco. And I'm just gonna go around the outer area just to do the ombre effect that I love. I'm gonna be using the Fenty Beauty primer today. This is the latest Beauty Blender color that they've released recently. I'm gonna use a Studio Finish concealer by MAC in NC35 to conceal around the brows. Concentration for the brows is serious, because if the brows mess up, the whole look is messed up. We're going for a really nude, warm toned look, so it's gonna be my forte. Using another product from Per Cosmetics, I'm using their beautiful palette. I think it's called Soiree Diaries, and it looks like this. Absolutely beautiful. And we're gonna be going for mainly like this type, this color, and a little bit of the yellow one here with a little bit of brown, hopefully. Okay, so I'm gonna start priming my eyes. I'm gonna be using the MAC concealer in NC40. I'm gonna use some translucent powder on top of that and just set all of that up to my brows. You know, me like you. Like so. So the daddy ramping thing called me when you want to. Blurge, which is this brown here. And I'm just gonna start blending this into my crease. I'm just taking a brush to blend out the outer area. And then go back in with the same color, and what you want to do is just keep layering this eyeshadow. Still using that same shadow and just layering it on. Next, I'm gonna take the shadow Mogul, which is a pale yellow color right here, the brow and kind of the center. I'm gonna take this shadow here, it's called Epic. I'm gonna deepen the look a little bit. They have this thing called Eye Polish. This is by Pear Cosmetics as well. And this one is in the shade Cashmere, and it comes with this thing. It's like a silicone end. It's not really a brush, and it's got little sparkles in it. And I'm gonna actually use this as a primer for the shimmer that I want to use. So I'm just putting a little bit of that right there. Eye glitters by Stila. It's either gonna be this champagne color or this more of a pink color. But I think I'm gonna go for the champagne color. I might even mix them together. A little bit of warmth. Why not? I'm trying so hard not to close my eyes. This is so funny. I'm gonna do it on the other eye. I really hope it dries. I've never actually used these before. So a lot of products I'm using today I've not actually used before. Of that dark shadow that I used on my brow, oh, it's transferring. I want to use that in my crease. Oh my god. I really wish I was filming this in a better professional way, because I feel like I'm just so all over the place in this video. But yeah, anyway. I feel like my eye needs to look extended and really elegant for this look. So that's what I'm attempting. Alright, so I'm gonna be putting on my lashes straight away. And I'm gonna be using these stunning lashes. I'll have the website from where they're from in the description box. Because I've extended my eye, I won't need to cut off any of the lash. I'm gonna let it get tacky on my eye. Who else loves Marley music? A trick I've mentioned many times before, I love to curl false lashes with my lashes because it really pushes the lash onto my natural lash line and it looks more natural. There's no like overlapping. I'm using this foundation, first time trying this foundation out, and it's the Tint Adore by Lancome in the shade 050. It matches really well with my neck. My face is a little bit lighter than the rest of my body, by the way. You might have noticed this already. And I think I've said it in all my videos. This was the closest match to me, by the way. All the lighter or darker shades were just... the undertone was completely off. This is the only one that has really strong olive yellow undertones. I love this foundation, how it feels. This concealer is just everything. My Orange Beauty Blender to blend everything. What I love about this concealer as well is you can layer it and it never gets cakey. And I'm gonna start with my forehead. I Oh my god, that looks crazy. I feel like I'm not speaking much in this video. I'm using Laura Mercier translucent powder for this. While that's all setting, I'm gonna put mascara and line my lip eyes once again. I'm using the Benefit mascara in Roller Lash, called Roller Lash. Coat these lashes with the same maroon color I used on my eyes. Oh yeah. I really hope my hair can reach this color sometime soon. I think there was blush on this brush, because it looks like I have blush on. Anyway, it doesn't matter. Okay, we've got highlighting and a few other things to do. I'm gonna use a highlighter that someone sent me from this Instagram brand, and I think I'm gonna use this gold one. Start with my all-time favorite, which is Strip Down. I love this color so much. This on top. I'm gonna put some more mascara on my bottom lashes. Thank you guys so much for watching my video. If you really enjoyed this look that I created, please, please, please give my video a thumbs up and comment down below what other videos you'd like to see. I'll see you guys in my next video. Love you guys. Bye.